Let's look at the next question. In this question, he said the causal realization of a system transfer function H of S having poles at 2, minus 1, minus 2, 1 and zeros at 2, 1, minus 2, minus 1 will be. And he gave the four options. Now, first of all, we'll try to draw the pole zero plot. Now, this is, he has given H of S means this corresponds to a continuous time system. So, I'm taking S plane. This is sigma. This is j omega. Now, let's plot the poles. Poles are located at what? 2 minus 1 means 2 minus j. So, this is 2 minus j means here the first pole is located. 2 minus j. 2 comma minus 1. So, this is minus j. Now, the next pole is located at minus 2 comma 1. Minus 2 comma 1 means this is 2, this is minus 2 comma 1, this is j, here is the other pole, second pole, and zeros at 2 comma 1, 2 comma 1, 2 plus j, locate the 0 here, this is the first 0, and the second 0 is located at minus 2 comma minus 1, this is minus 2 minus j, so this will be your second 0. Now, this is the pole zero plot. Now, if you observe this pole zero plot for a continuous time system, if you observe here, these zeros and poles are mirror images. If poles and zeros are mirror image for a continuous time system, it represents an all-pass system. So, this corresponds to an all-pass filter. Here, poles and zeros are mirror image. So, this corresponds to all-pass system. So, your answer can be option 1 or option 2. Now, let's look at the next observation. That is, here if you observe, now we have to determine whether our system is complex or real. And we know that for a real system, poles and zeros form complex conjugate pairs. Means, if I have 0 at 2 plus j, the other 0 must be at 2 minus j. For a real system, poles and zeros, they form complex conjugate pairs. So, 0 at 2 plus j means the other 0 must be at 2 minus j, which is not so here. At 2 minus j, we have a pole. So, this is not a real system. So, this is a complex system. So, this one is satisfied. And if you look at the given question, he said is a causal system. And we have one famous statement that for a causal LTI system to be stable, all the poles must lie on the left half of S plane, or the poles must have negative real parts. Now, if you observe, one pole is lying on the right half of S plane, which is having a positive real part. So, this cannot be a stable system. So, unstable. So, unstable, complex and all pass. These three are satisfied. So, option 1 becomes your answer.